The Rongai route starts from the little village of Nale Moru at a height of just over 6,400 feet, and it eventually enters a pine forest that shelters a variety of wildlife. As the forest thins out, we arrive at our first camp at 8,500 feet, with a clear view of Mawenzi, one of the three volcanic peaks on Kili.
We're off to camp two. Fantastic little shelter. We all had a great night's sleep here last night. Here's wonderful Kilimanjaro in the background. Where the destination will be in 4 days now.
Our second day is a steady ascent up to our second camp at just under 12,000 feet. Keeping our climbing peak, Kibo, always in firm sight. On our third day, we continue our ascent, leaving vegetation behind to reach an altitude of just over 14,000 feet to Mawenzi Tarn, which is situated directly beneath the towering spires of Mawenzi. We continue trekking for a further 5 hours to reach the Kibo hut, which will be our base camp. Crossing the lunar desert of the saddle between Mawenzi and Kibo.
Looks like a Grand Prix here, everybody's drafting each other.
We are now approaching base camp, situated at the bottom of the Kibo crater wall. Altitude 15,500 feet.
Right. We're now.
Okay.
preparations for the summit bid. It's now about 11:15 p.m. and we're ready to climb 5 hours to Gillman's Point and then another 2 hours to the roof of Africa.
I'm climbing about 200 yards to the Kazi.
Yep, Kazi's out of the way first. Imodium's on the go.
Imodium party.
Mount Kilimanjaro has three volcanic cones, Shira, Mawenzi, and the highest, Kibo, which is our objective, and we hope to reach Gillman's Point by sunrise. A further 2 hours later, we reach the summit, Uhuru Peak, the highest point in Africa, at just under 19,500 feet.
Congratulations to you.
Tu na malisa.
our final glimpse of Kibo.
Protea Kimadiskarika, which are known as a wild protea. South African's national flower.
Na uhuru yetu,
hakuna matata.